Let's make some deli salad. Here I have some radishes and cucumbers and carrots and cabbage. And let me see, peppers and onions. And if I had some celery, I'd be using it. And any kind of vegetable that you want. The next thing I'd like to do is soak some of these vegetables in a little bit of vinegar and water just to get all the pesticides off. And I usually soak it for about 10 minutes. I like to cut the vegetables in little pieces, and I'm using a knife with holes in it. It makes it zero resistance and much easier to cut up the vegetables. I place the cabbage in a big salad bowl, and I could still cut it like this to make it a little bit more fine. Okay, now I'm cutting up the carrots. Now I'm cutting up some onions. And if you have green onions, by all means use them, or if you have celery or any kind of vegetables that you don't want to spoil, by all means put it in your deli salad. Here I have some cucumbers I quartered and I left the skin on, and now I am going to cut them in maybe half inch pieces. Okay, let's cut our radishes in half and just cut them up in maybe half inch slices. Let's cut up our peppers. And I take the stems off, but I use the seeds because they're very good to eat. And cut them up in maybe, I don't know, half inch slices, that'll be fine. I have put all my cut up vegetables in this big salad bowl, and it looks absolutely delicious. Now I am going to add some sea salt. You don't want to add salt that has caking agents in it. And I am going to start mixing it with my hands, and it is going to start fermenting. And we all know the value of fermented foods. Gut bacteria, 80% of our immune system is in the gut, not to mention neurotransmitters. When we don't have enough gut bacteria, we get sick and we get hungry and we crave for foods. Just keep adding salt to taste, taste it, mix it. And keep in mind, we are growing good bacteria that is going to be in our gut. So far, I've added about a third cup of salt. Try to mix it. Go to the bottom and put the bottom on top. And that's a great way of mixing it. Notice the volume of my salad has really come down. That's because the salt has caused the fermentation process to begin. Now I'm going to add a half a cup of olive oil. You may use any kind of non-hydrogenated oil. And now it's time to mix it thoroughly. In a blender, I'm adding a third cup of organic apple cider vinegar. You can use lemon juice. Three garlic cloves with the skin. The skin has its own nutrients. And a little dab of Dijon mustard. Now blend. And if you don't have a blender, just grate the garlic in. Now pour it onto your salad and mix it thoroughly with your hands. It is now good to eat. And if you're making it for a party, make it the night before because it's more delicious the next day. For fermentation, we use clean jars, not sterile jars. Here I've stuffed the rest of the salad in jars, and you want to squeeze down the salad as much as possible to get the air out and to cover the salad with liquid so it lasts for weeks and months, not years, and I'll be putting this in the fridge. Put the lids on and always, always date your work.